it will come on a Friday. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the hour will come all of a sudden without you even realizing it. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that before a transaction takes place, the hour will come. Before the person lifts a morsel to his mouth, before the morsel reaches his mouth, the hour will take place. And Allah the Almighty will order Israfil alayhi salam to blow through the horn. This angel is such that his eyes are fixed on the throne of the Creator. This angel is such, the one ring of his horn is bigger than the east and west put together. This angel is such that he does not blink. Why? Fearing that he'll miss the command of Allah. And when he blows through the horn, the Himalayas, the K2, the Everest, they will come to an end. The hadith of Abu Huraira comes to mind that the earth will shake, and the earth will shake in such a manner. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You will see it will be like a vessel in the middle of the ocean getting battered by tornadoes. The horn is so terrifying. Allahu Akbar. You will see a mother who's got a baby in her stomach. When she hears the horn, she will miscarry her baby. Why? Because the sound of the horn is so terrifying. That child who's only 10 years old, 15 years old, 16 years old, his face will turn wrinkly, his hair will turn white, he will look like a person who's over 100. Why? Because this is the day of reckoning. And when this is taking place, the mother who's got a child, she on that day will remember that she had a child. Why? Because the sound of the horn. The sound of the horn is so terrifying that you will see mankind will be in a drunken state, but in reality they won't be drunk. The hadith of Abu Huraira comes to mind. He said the shaitan and his army will begin to run and they will begin to hide. They will begin to run and they will begin to hide. The Quran says on that day there is no refuge. He will look above the people and what will they see? They will see the sky will look like the black filth of oil. It will crack piece by piece. The earth beneath them, it will crack piece by piece. The oceans will be on fire on that day and they will explode from their places. Allahu Akbar, picture this in your mind. That the oceans, they will be on fire and they will explode from their places. The stars will lose their shine and they will come crashing down and there'll be darkness everywhere. And when there is darkness everywhere, nothing will remain. Every single thing in the universe will come to an end. The hadith of Abu Huraira says that the angel of death, it will say to Allah, "Oh Allah, all those are in the heaven and all those are in the dunya. They have come to an end except for those who you wish to remain alive, O Allah." Allah will say, "Who remains?" And the angel will say, "O Allah, Jibreel remains, Mikael remains, Israfil remains, and the angels who are carrying your throne, they remain." Allah the Almighty will say, "Let death come to Jibreel, let death come to Mikael, let death come to Israfil, and let death come to all those angels who are carrying my throne." Then Allah will say, "Who remains?" Yeah, Allah knows who remains. Allah will say to the angel of death, "Who remains?" And the angel will say, "Oh Allah, I remain, you remain, no one else remains." Yet then Allah will say, "I created you for a purpose. You have fulfilled your purpose. You also die," and he will die. And then Allah the Almighty, he will roll up all the heavens in his hands. He will roll up all the worlds in his hands. And Allah will raise his voice and Allah will say, "I am the Almighty Allah. I am the Almighty Allah. For whom is the divine rule today? For whom is the power today? For whom is the kingdom today? I am the king of all kings. Where are your dictators? Where are your oppressors? No one will answer. Allah himself will answer. And Allah will say, power is for Allah. Might is for Allah. The one, the only, the irresistible. And when this happens, the narration says, the earth will be made flat and will be like a stretched rubber. He, Allah the Almighty, He will order the heavens to pour rain. And the heavens will pour rain for 40 days. And the water, a certain liquid that is classed as water, will reach 12 cubits. And then Allah the Almighty, He will say to the bodies, form, and they will form. And when they reach their complete, Allah the Almighty will say, Jibreel, Mikael, Israfil, Malak al-Maut, come to life, and they will come to life. And then Allah the Almighty will say, bring the souls, and the souls of the believers will come, and they will be bright. Then the souls of the disbelievers will come, and they will be bore on the plain, and they will be dark and murky. Then Allah will order the souls to be placed in the horn, and then Allah the Almighty will order the angel Israfil alayhi salam to blow through the horn, and this angel will blow, and it will give it such a blow that the hadith states that the souls will come out like a swarm of bees, and they will cover the heavens and the earth, and they will enter their bodies, and everybody will be awake. They'll be naked, they'll be uncircumcised, they'll be barefooted, and they'll be looking forward. The hadith states, picture this in your mind, the person who done wudu, who done wudu with perfection, Allahu Akbar, on the plain of resurrection, there'll be light covering his hand, there'll be light covering his face, there'll be light covering his head, there'll be light covering his feet, there'll be light in front of him, there'll be light behind him, there'll be light on the left, there'll be light on the right, there'll be light in front, the light behind, light will be surrounding him. Allahu Akbar, then comes the Hujjaj, they'll be on the plain of resurrection, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. They will be saying, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik. There'll be light in front of them, there'll be light behind them, there'll be light on the left, there'll be light on the right, they'll be surrounded by light. Then comes the warriors of Islam. They will be on the plain of resurrection. Some will be holding their own intestines, some will be holding their own limbs, their blood will be flowing, their blood will smell like musk. There'll be light in front of them, light behind them, light on the left, light on the right, light will be surrounding them. Then comes the Muazzin. He will be on the plain of resurrection, and he will be giving the adhan, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And he will continuously do the adhan. There'll be light in front of him, there'll be light behind him, there'll be light on the left, there'll be light on the right, he'll be surrounded by light. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. These are for the good people. Now comes the junkie, now comes the druggie, the very spliff he took, the very sniff he took, he'll be on the plane of resurrection. The crack, the weed, the opium, the white lady, you name it, will be wrapped around his neck. His tongue will come down towards his waist like a thirsty dog. Between his skin and his flesh, there'll be snakes and scorpions biting him. He'll be made to wear the slippers of hell that make his brain bubble like a boiling water in a kettle. That person who fornicated, he'll be on that plane of resurrection. Allahu Akbar, his private part will be placed on his face, his blood and pus will flow from it, and the prophets of Allah, his mother, his father, every single person on the plane of resurrection will know that this guy is the fornicator. The one who backbites, his face will be on the plane of resurrection in such a manner, Allahu Akbar, his face will be transformed into a monkey. The person who deals with haram, he'll be on the plane of resurrection. His face will be transformed into a pig. Allahu Akbar, the person who deals with interest, he'll be walking on his face. The two-faced guy will be on the plane of resurrection in such manner that he'll have two physical faces. In another narration,